Okay, number two, suppose alpha is a quadrant 2 angle with sine alpha is 12 thirteenths. Find the cosine of alpha. Okay, so how are we supposed to do that? Well, first off, we have to see if this is reasonable. XY. All we know about alpha is that it's a quadrant 2 angle to start off with. We don't know if alpha is positive or negative or how many times it's gone around. So all we can do is we know the initial side is the positive x-axis, and the terminal side is somewhere over here in quadrant 2. Okay, so this is the terminal side of alpha. What else are we given? We're given the sine of alpha is 12 thirteenths. So that means if I superimpose the unit circle, all we know is, see, unit circle here, the highest we can go is 1. 12 thirteenths is pretty darn close to that. Okay, so this is all we know about alpha. How are we supposed to find the cosine of alpha? Well, we use the big identity. We know that cosine squared of an angle plus sine squared of that same angle is always equal to 1. That's the Pythagorean identity. That works for every angle. And so cosine of alpha is what I'm trying to find. Sine squared of alpha, remember what this means. This means sine of alpha squared. So we're going to take that 12 thirteenths, which is what we're given, and square that, and that's supposed to be 1. So cosine squared alpha plus, and remember from arithmetic, when you square a fraction, you square the top, square the bottom. So that's 144 over 169, and that's equal to 1. Subtract 144 over 169. You get 1 minus 144 over 169. I don't want to belabor the arithmetic here, but you get the common denominators of 169 over 169. So you get 25 over 169. And then we extract square roots here, cosine alpha, plus or minus 25 over 169, which is plus or minus square root of 25 is 5, square root 169 is 13, plus or minus 5 thirteenths. Now, which of these do we pick? That's the next question, and that all depends on the angle alpha. We know alpha is a quadrant 2 angle, and in quadrant 2, the x-coordinate, which is going to be the cosine, the x-coordinate of this point on the unit circle is going to be negative, so that's going to be negative. So our final answer, which we'll have to tuck in over here, cosine of alpha is negative 5 thirteenths. So that'll do it for number 2. Okay, number 3, we're to suppose the terminal side of theta contains the point 3, comma, negative 4. Find cosine theta and sine theta. So we're assuming here when we write this that theta is, of course, in standard position. So let's sketch out this situation here. 3, comma, negative 4. So once again, we don't know what direction we've rotated. We don't know how far we've rotated. We just know that the vertex and initial side are along the positive x-axis, and then the terminal side, whatever it is, contains the point P, 3, comma, negative 4. Okay, so that's the point P, 3, negative 4. All right, so we go back and we have a theorem from the book that tells us that the cosine of theta is going to be x divided by the square root of x squared plus y squared, and the sine of theta is going to be y over the square root of x squared plus y squared. So remember, this x squared plus y squared square root, that's going to be the radius. And so we're basically shrinking this thing back to the unit circle by doing this. So that's the radius there, square root x squared plus y squared. So we can go ahead and just run through the computations here. Cosine of theta is going to be x, 3, over the square root of x squared, 3 squared, plus y squared, negative 4 squared. Sine of theta is going to be y, negative 4, over the same square root. So I get cosine of theta. Let's see, that's 9 plus 16. That's 25. Square root 25 is 5. 3 fifths. Sine of theta, negative 4 fifths. That'll do it for number 3. Okay, number 4, instead of given an angle and finding the sine or cosine, we're now asked to find all the angles that have a sine of negative 1 half. So let's think geometrically what's happening here. What do we know about theta if the sine is negative 1 half? Well, we know that if we plot theta in standard position, so the vertex at the origin and the initial side along the positive x-axis, that the terminal side of theta must lie in either quadrants 3 or 4. Why is that? Well, remember what the sine is. The sine is the y-coordinate of the point on the terminal side of theta which intersects the unit circle. So where are the y-coordinates negative? They're negative in quadrants 3 and quadrants 4. So that means that theta is either a quadrant 3 or a quadrant 4 angle. What else do we know about theta? Well, sine of theta is negative 1 half. That means that the reference angle for theta, which we call alpha, is going to be 30 degrees pi over 6. And since we're not specifying degrees or radians, we always default to radians because it's radians that we can identify with real numbers. Alright, so we have two cases. One case is it's a quadrant 3 angle. One case it's a quadrant 4 angle. So for the quadrant 3 angle case, what can theta be? Well, what's one quadrant 3 angle with a reference angle of pi over 6? Well, I start and go halfway around. Halfway around in radian measure is pi, which is 6 pi over 6. So I go an extra pi over 6. This gives me 7 pi over 6. And then, of course, any angle coterminal with that will also have a sine of negative 1 half. So we add multiples of 2 pi, where k, once again, is an integer. So this completely describes all quadrant 3 angles whose sine is negative 1 half. Each of these angles have a reference angle of pi over 6, which means their sine is going to be negative 1 half. Quadrant 4. What's the name of one quadrant 4 angle with a reference angle of pi over 6? Well, if I go all the way around, it's 2 pi, which is 12 pi over 6, but I need to back up pi over 6, so that's 11 pi over 6. So here's one quadrant 4 angle with the sine of negative 1 half, and all the other angles must be coterminal with that. And so these are our two solutions. All right, so unlike in algebra, where we might get three or four solutions, in trigonometry it's very common to get infinitely many solutions. So that'll do it for number 4.